Hi guys, welcome to a brand new episode of Life Beyond TikTok. On our very new episode, we have Chanel Charuki with us. Hi, how are you doing today?
Hi, I'm doing great.
Shout out to our venue partner, Tea Avenue, our hair and makeup partner, The Beauty Quest Colombo, our wardrobe partner, Jello Clothing, and our fabulous gift partner, The Cake Boutique. So tell us a bit about yourself.
So firstly, I want to thank you for having me here today. And as you mentioned earlier, I'm Chanel Charuki. I'm 16 years old. I also have a little brother who's 11. I still obviously live with my parents. And I have a passion for fashion. And my end goal is to have my own clothing label one day.
Alright, so what are you doing these days?
So after completing my O-levels at Stafford International School, I enrolled at the Academy of Design. And I'm currently pursuing a degree in fashion and textile design. And I actually just finished my semester one submissions like 3 days ago. So yeah, so I'm like waiting for my second semester to start. And apart from that, I'm just at home really, because there's hardly any chance of going out these days because of the current tense situation in the country. So yeah.
Alright, so what was your first thought when you realized that you want to make your social media public?
So when I got a phone for the first time, I really didn't have any idea about what social media was because I was 11 at the time. And also my parents were not very keen with me posting content publicly. But then after some time with age, my parents let me post publicly. And to be honest, at the beginning, I was quite nervous. But also excited at the same time because I wasn't really sure how people were going to react to my content. So yeah, that's basically how it started.
Alright, so in your opinion, what is TikTok about?
I think that TikTok is a great platform for people to express themselves through various means. And I've seen people from different ethnicities, different social backgrounds, all kind of just like unite and have found TikTok to be a perfect platform to express themselves and share it with the world.
Alright, so can you tell me a bit about how you got started on social media? When did it start?
Okay, so as I mentioned earlier, so I got my phone and then I actually downloaded an app called Musical.ly. Oh. I don't know if you heard of it before, yes. But TikTok was actually Musical.ly way before it was rebranded to TikTok. So I've been on it since it was Musical.ly. And then I started off by creating videos mainly based on dance, singing covers and playing the guitar. That was my hobby at the time, and then I eventually downloaded Instagram. And I downloaded Instagram for the sole purpose of trying to find people who had similar interests in what I did. And like I used it as a tool to find content that I can relate to and follow, like to be inspired by. So, yeah.
So how often do you get negative comments on Instagram, TikTok and all, and how do you deal with it?
Okay, so when it comes to negative comments, so you know, I was obviously new to this whole thing, and at the beginning when I was when I first posted content, I kept my comment section on because I was expecting people to kind of just like my content like automatically. But then I soon realized that that's not the case, that even though I expected positivity, that there were people who had negative thoughts too. And at first I was quite disheartened and sad about it because I always try to put maximum effort and time into all the content I create. But then like I went through a few like TikTokers content and I realized that it's not just for me. Like in general, there's always going to be someone who's going to say something negatively. So yeah, so then I figured that, you know, everyone's entitled to their own opinion and we should respect that, and as long as we can provide good quality content, we can just like kind of just like disregard the negativity and focus on the positives. But that also doesn't mean that I don't care about the negative comments, because sometimes those negative comments actually make sense.
Yeah,
and it has actually like helped me improve as a person, and it has helped me improve my content as well. So yeah.
Sri Lanka is a country with a lot of cyberbullying. So what are your thoughts on this?
Yeah, that is true. And I think it's crazy how some people actually enjoy bullying and commenting negatively on things. I just think it's so disrespectful. But the thing is, I have realized that it's not only cyberbullying is not only limited to Sri Lanka. It actually spread throughout the world, and I think that it should stop because it's really not cool. And in my short experience from being on social media, I have come to realize that I should always respect every person's point of view. And also, if I don't find someone's content appealing to me, I just simply unfollow them. Yeah, no one's forcing you to follow them.
So did social media change your life? If yes, how?
Okay, so of course it did. Okay, like the opportunities I've gotten as a result of creating content is mass, and like opportunities that I could only like dream of. And I've also got the opportunity of meeting a lot of amazing people and interacting with them, like with different parts of life. So yeah, I'm just like super grateful.
Hello, we downtown LA, ghetto. She got her ass on her pillow. Girl, shake that A, jello. 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 Jello.
Jello.
Jello.
Jello. Jello.
Jello. Alright, so as a person who is capable of influencing people, so what do you think about the role of an influencer?
Okay, so I think that influencing should always be done in a positive manner, because as a public figure, when you are a public figure with a good, loyal fan base, you have to be mindful and socially responsible with what you publish to the public. Because like I have seen influencing, I have seen like influencers like promoting things negatively and positively at the same time. So I just think in my point of view, in whatever role that I can play as an influencer, I always want to be responsible towards the community and society with what I post.
All right, so who are your top five favorite TikTokers?
Okay, the thing is, okay, so there's Alexandra Lords. She's a female entrepreneur and she's also a mom, and she owns like these restaurants in LA, and she just really inspires me when it comes to the business aspect of things. And then there's Hesara. I don't know if you've heard of him, but he's a local TikToker and he makes like these comedy funny videos. Yeah, that's him. And then there's another local TikToker called Wild Cookbook. He makes like the coolest like cooking videos, and like I don't know, it just looks so delicious. So yeah, then another international TikToker is called Cool Kid Nelly. He's all about dancing and like vibing to music, which is what I'm all about. And then lastly, I would say Michaela. I really enjoy watching like makeup videos and like transitions. So yeah.
All right, so if you could change one thing in Sri Lanka, what would it be?
Okay, so what would I change? Okay, so I'm only 16. And like I'm still studying, so when it comes to the, I'm not very familiar with the political side of things, but I have come to understand that that at this point in life people are finding it very difficult at the moment. Like I have seen a lot of people suffering, and I would love to change that by giving them happiness, a peace of mind and comfort to the people in suffering, because I feel that that's what they require the most at this point in life. Yeah.
Alright, so my last question for you is, what is your message to people out there who's willing to build a career through social media?
I would say whatever you put your mind into, always do it in a proper civilized manner, and just always be authentic, spread positivity, you know, positive good vibes, and always be socially responsible and mindful of what you post publicly. And also I would say, most importantly, you should respect everyone's point of view, and also and like be humble for sure. So with the little knowledge that I have, I think that if you follow these simple guidelines, that you too can be a successful and influential person.
Alright, so thank you so much for coming today, and we have a small token of appreciation from the cake boutique by Radhi.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
We'll catch you.